389 Gaming.
Hey guys, it's Guy389 here, and welcome back to the first episode, or first real episode of Minecraft in Space. So this episode's going to be post-commentary, and for good reason. And also, it's a good thing I did this in post-commentary, because the audio that I was recording over last time was bugged out. Or, sorry, not the audio, but the video I was recording this audio for was bugged out when I was trying to record for it. So I got about 20 minutes in and then had to start the whole thing over again because VLC just crashed, straight up. It just said, nope, not gonna do it. Crash. No idea what exactly caused that, but... You know, sometimes my videos, when I render them out, they just, you know, bug out completely. And you have what happened to me, where every 3 seconds the video will just stop. And it will frame skip and crash and do all sorts of stuff. Anyways, the main reason that I'm doing this in post-commentary is because I wanted to focus on building the structure. And it's kind of like what I did with the tower in... previous series, Minecraft in the Sky, in that I built the entire tower more or less off camera so that I could, you know, focus on it and do a good job with it. And also it took me multiple days to complete. This took about, or the build that I'm doing right now took about 3 hours. So anyways, I don't have anything scripted for this, so I'm just... I don't have anything scripted for this, so I'm just going to talk freely through the video. I'll give you guys a few updates on, you know, what's going on, what I'll be doing with this series, and a number of other things. I'll also talk a little bit about the build itself as we get along with it. And... hopefully I can stay enthusiastic, even though this is the second time I'm recording virtually the same thing. Oh, VLC and Windows Movie Maker. You art silly. Especially Windows Movie Maker, because it makes really weird files sometimes. It's like you can process a file twice and it will be completely different both times. Like, it'll crash in one, and the other one will be just fine. It's also a good thing I played through it, because most of the episode was fine, and then just, like, midway through it, it just stopped working. So, anywho, let's talk a little bit about what I'll be doing with this series in particular. I probably won't be able to keep up with the... two videos a week schedule that I had before. Mainly because I have a lot to do nowadays. Because, you know, I'm working on my master's thesis. And, yes, I'm still working on it. And working is, you know, a relative term. I'm trying to work at it. But obviously it's... a lot more monotonous and annoying than I would like. So, yeah, I haven't gotten as far as I'd like to, is what I'm trying to say. And it may actually drag on until next year. In fact, I have to wait until next year to hand it in due to a mishap that happened earlier this year. I did not attend a seminar that I was supposed to attend because I had to work. And apparently, needing to make money and feed yourself to survive is not a legitimate excuse to not go to class, because the university is not built around you actually having a job alongside your education. But the student loans that you can get are not sufficient for you to even pay your rent. So you have to work alongside your education to be able to actually do it. Either that, or you have to have rich parents that pay for everything for you. And there are a couple people I know of that get that kind of treatment. But I am not one of those people, so I have to pay for myself, and in order to do that, I have to work. And in order to live the life that I want to live, I have to work. Which means that I essentially have two full-time jobs. I have a full-time job working on my master's thesis and a full-time job, or, well, not a full-time job, but a mostly full-time job. I'd say about 60-70% job working at a store. So it's a lot to do, and I'm also looking into another job because the current job I have, you would think that working in a store would involve not taking your work home with you, but I end up taking a lot of work home with me. Or at least a lot of the work that I do has an impact on my life outside of work as well. So I'm hoping to get a different job, which hopefully will have a less negative impact on my life outside of work so that I can focus on working on my master's thesis and getting that finished. However, I will still try to post more frequently than I have been recently. So I've only been posting videos, I guess, every other week or so, sometimes less frequently than that. And I've actually been losing subscribers from it just because, people think I'm not active anymore. They don't see my videos going up every now and then. And I know that people don't check every day to see if I posted a video, so if I don't post regularly, then people think that I haven't posted at all, and I lose subscribers from that. So I'm gonna try to keep up at least once a week, and maybe twice a week when I have time, but I'm not gonna make any official promises on that. But I may very well end up focusing a lot on this series just because it's a little easier for me to crank out. I can kind of do this in my spare time, and it's not too hard to produce Minecraft content. It's a little harder with some other games because there are a lot of other games that don't lend themselves very well to YouTube, both in the forms of copyright strikes and in the form of gameplay that is not as cool to watch as it is to play, like the 4X games that I was doing. They're not always as fun to watch, and because I have to concentrate when I'm doing them, I'm not able to be as energetic, which is one of the reasons that I'm going away from the Armada 2526 Let's Try that I was doing, just because I didn't feel like the commentary was up to par. And also the visuals were terrible because I had to go through so many loopholes just to record it. It's like, I don't even know how they made that game. I don't know. It uses some kind of video system that Fraps doesn't recognize at all. And also, the program I was using to record it as a flash file, which would allow me to adjust the size and just basically film the screen within the parameters of the video, or around the borders of the video. That wouldn't run in Windows Media Player, so I had to record the video file that it produced. I had to play the video file in VLC and record it with Fraps. And that's why it was really, really, really jittery, and the graphics were just not great, and the video was not fluid at all. It was like 6 frames per second. And it was just a little bit sad, really, because I had a lot of fun playing it. It's a good game. But yeah, if you have to jump through so many loopholes and the payoff is that low, and also I was losing, like people, I think 24 people watched the first one, and it dropped down to 7 by the third one. Just, people weren't interested in it Or at the very least, people didn't seem interested in it, so I'm probably not going to do it anymore, just because it's a pain in the butt to record. I also have been trying to do an FTL playthrough. I tried a modded playthrough of it, and I just couldn't keep the audio going. Any game where I have to concentrate too much is a little bit difficult. I guess that's the ADHD causing that. But yeah, I can't keep up with my thoughts, and I get distracted. But then again, Let's Playing isn't particularly easy either. If you've ever tried it, you kind of know that, you know, when you're Let's Playing, you're focused on two things at once, so you're obviously only able to use, you know, half of your normal brain power to actually do the tasks that you're trying to do. Another good reason why I did this in post-commentary, because I had to focus a little bit here. I also got really lucky with this, because as you can see, I'm floating over the void right now. And for those of you who are new to the series, I'm not actually cheating. I don't have creative or anything. I just have admin abilities, which means I can fly around a little bit, but all of the resources I'm using are actually mined and manufactured by moi. If you are a returning viewer of this series, then welcome back. I should have probably put that disclaimer early in the video, but it's like people will log in and they're like, oh, he's cheating, hacks, and then leave the video and put a dislike and everything like that. But yeah, whatever, doesn't matter. The important thing is that the people that enjoy it are enjoying it. And also, I had quite a few requests to bring this series back. Oh, and right here I actually messed up completely, which is why I edited that. I ended up counting. I spent my time counting this and thinking I had it right. And then I was off. And then it took me forever to fix it. But, you know, that's what it ended up looking like, is that nice little broadside there. I actually kind of like it. It's simple. I'm a simple person. So anyways, how are you guys? What have you guys been up to? Post in the comment section below if you've been playing Minecraft. Post in the comment section below if you haven't been playing Minecraft. Post in the comment section below if you would like to post in the comment section below. And actually, I would very much appreciate if you guys posted in the comment section, because I'm interested to hear what people have to say, you know, both about what I'm doing in my videos and, you know, what you guys would like to see, and just, you know, generally what you guys are interested in, because, you know, it's neat to talk to people. And I am fortunate enough to have few enough subscribers to where I can actually communicate with all or most of my subscribers. And this is one thing I don't like about building in the end. These guys, they will spawn in troves as soon as they have a spot to spawn in. So if you have, like, one spot that they can spawn in, you'll have, like, 30 of them in a few minutes. Sorry, hiccuped again. I was obviously eating recently. Actually, I wasn't. I have no idea why I'm hiccuping. I don't know. I'm also sick, which is another reason I did this in post-commentary, because I would be sneezing and coughing and everything if I was also focused on building and doing live commentary. It also doesn't help that I cut the video like a million times, and it's going to get more frequent. So anyways, recently I've been playing Pokemon X and Y. Post in the comment section below if you also have been playing Pokemon X and Y. And yes, I am still 25 years old, and I play Pokemon, and I am proud of it. I actually, Pokemon X and Y is the first Pokemon game in a long time that I've really enjoyed, like, straight up. It may be because I went out and bought my brother a 2DS and got him Pokemon X and Y. But, oh, and I made a mistake and I noticed it. Oh no, what am I gonna do? Have to fix it. So anyways, I've been playing Pokemon X and Y, and I've been enjoying it a lot more than Black and White 2. I don't know why. I think Black and White 2 is just too grindy for me. I have Black 2. I don't know if it's less grindy in White 2, but I think they're about the same. But still, you know, it just feels too grindy for me. Like, it takes too long to level up, and it's less enjoyable overall. For it. It takes the same amount of time to level up, but you just don't... I don't know what it is. I just don't feel like the game is progressing at a normal rate, and like, some of the caves are just too long and stuff like that. But right now, I'm very much enjoying X and Y. I also enjoy that... Or I also very much appreciate that you can get a decent... and versatile party very early in the game. I know they did that a little bit with Black and White, but I didn't feel like I had a versatile party, like, towards midway through the game. Like, all the Pokemon I wanted to have in my party started showing up about halfway through. And it just didn't pan out as well as I hoped it would. But, you know, it's been fun. And I've been enjoying it. And that matters a lot. Because I didn't enjoy Black and White 2 as much. And, yeah, I didn't really enjoy Heart Gold, Soul Silver that much either. I have Soul Silver, not Heart Gold. Even though, like, the nostalgia factor is there. Because Crystal for the Game Boy Color was... Well, I guess it is still my favorite in the series. It's, at the very least, the game I played the most. Because, you know, I played it... I don't know, I had 3 playthroughs on Crystal, 1 playthrough on Silver, and 1 playthrough on Gold. And all of my most recent ones were over 300 hours on each. And then I had 3 playthroughs on Crystal, which were all 300 to 200 hour, or 200 or 300 hours of playthrough time. So we were talking like thousands of hours of time invested into that game. And obviously, you know, I was a kid back then, so I had the time to do that. I can't really do that anymore. I can't really invest that much time into the game. I still invest a bit of time into it. I have... I think 400 hours logged on Diamond and Pearl. And Ruby and Sapphire I played through twice. With over 100 hours each. I think 200 hours on the most recent one. So about 300 hours on that too. So I have invested some time into those. But then again, in like Heart Gold and Soul Silver, I was... I kind of like... wandered around a lot because I was a kid, not, you know, didn't do things in a focused manner or do things efficiently. I just sort of wandered around and did whatever. Whereas I was a teenager when I had Ruby and Sapphire, and an adult when I got Diamond and Pearl. I think I was I 18 or 19 when I got Diamond and Pearl? I can't remember. It really doesn't matter, but, you know. I'm old. I might have been 20, because I don't really remember when it came out. But I actually enjoyed Diamond and Pearl a lot. And, yeah, I just liked it. It was a good... a good, well-balanced experience, and it had a lot you could do after the game was over in the form of the battle tower, and you had the excavation stuff or the archaeology stuff where you could go looking for fossils. Yeah, it was just good. It was a good game. But X and Y seems like a pretty good game, and I was actually pretty skeptical as to whether or not I would actually buy it for a while. The runway's more or less done there. And now, the epic stare down with the torch. Alright, the torch won, so I punched it in the face. Now to build the entrance, or the opening, or whatever you want to call it. The hangar bay. The hangar bay is done, but you get what I mean. The pathway into the hangar. The hole. I'm just sizing it up, because I'm not quite sure what's going on here. But yeah, this build actually turned out pretty well, so I'm looking forward to showing you guys the finished product once it's done. You'll get to see that at the end of this video. So what else have I been up to? I've been working on... I've obviously been working on my thesis and stuff, but... I hope that didn't come into the audio, but there was a little pling there. I've been working on my thesis a bit, especially today, and I also went and got my hair cut. My hair was way too long, so I went and sorted that out. It cost me 427 kroner. I know that doesn't make any sense to you guys who may or may not use kroner, but if I'm going to translate that into dollars, let's see, it's 6 kroner to $1, about, or 7, 6 or 7 to a dollar, but let's say 6, just to get this to a more reasonable number. I think it might actually be 5.9, now that I think about it. Alright, so 40 divided by 6 is... I can't even remember it. I know 42. 42 is 7. Yeah, 42 is 7, so... Yeah, that's actually pretty close. $70. About $70 for a haircut. There we go. I made the entranceways a little bit more colorful. I tried to add a little bit of color into this because I don't want it to be too plain. But I also wanted this to be a little bit minimalistic. Like, not very resource-heavy, just, like, lots and lots of stone, but... Yeah, I wanted it to look fancy and detailed as well, because... Well, why not? I mean, I have nearly infinite resources, because I've spent so much time mining, but... Yeah, you know, I like to keep some stuff around. I like to keep one stack of... lapis and one stack of redstone, and one stack of coal and everything like that in my ender chest in the event of an emergency. Like, put it somewhere where it can't be stolen, it can't be destroyed, it can't disappear. If they decide to regenerate the server, it'll still be there as soon as I get a hold of it, as long as they don't delete the entire map file. If they regenerate the server, or regenerate the map, then it's not a problem, but if they delete the entire server file, it will also delete the contents of Ender Chest. But yeah, I have some stuff stored away in my Ender Chest as, like, reserves. And I don't want to tap into those at the moment. And now back to our Minecraft in the Sky for a little bit. I thought we would visit the house, you know, have a look around, and just enjoy our stay here for a little bit. Maybe relax, take a break from building. And let's head up to... Right. Can't close the door. Weird. Alright, let's have a look around. The chests are all empty. Let's head up to my room. Oh, didn't mean to do that. Yeah, better do something about that. So guys, we're finally going to do something about that staircase. For those of you who've been following the series, you know that that staircase has never been fixed. Or never been built, actually. Oh, sorry, I knocked the mic around there for a second. No, not jungle wood, birch wood. So I thought, while I was taking a quick break and waiting for glass to cook, that we would take a look around here and fix that staircase. Actually, I wasn't planning on fixing the staircase. I was just taking a look around, you know, for the sake of it. But I ended up fixing the staircase, and now we finally have an actual staircase. And back to building. So now we've got most of the exterior done, so I figured I'd spend a little bit of time building the interior as well. And I ended up just, you know, finishing the entire thing. So you'll get to see the more or less finished product. It's not completely finished because I want to put a little bit more furnishing into it. But it is finished-ish. So another thing I've been playing is I've been playing a lot of DayZ Epoch. I don't know if you guys are interested or excited about that kind of stuff, but in the event that you are, I do actually, or my brother actually, rather, has a server for it. Now, I'm not going to make that public, just because we don't really want other people on the server. And more importantly, we're probably going to reset it pretty soon, because one of the problems with Epoch at the moment is it's way too easy to get... Way too easy to get good loot early. So we have a couple of storage sheds full of weapons, ammo, food, medical supplies, like everything. So, and we have like 8 night visions or something, 8 night vision goggles. I don't remember. We have way too much loot for our own good. And because it's a private server, we don't have to worry about losing our loot too much. Because if we die, all that happens is we just go back and, you know, get more loot. Or go back and get our loot. I don't know why I didn't edit this part out, because this is completely unnecessary. You guys don't need to see this. Oh well, it doesn't matter. You get to see me run a little bit back and forth to the chests. I thought I edited out most of it, but didn't edit this part. So anyway, I was thinking of whether or not you guys might want to see live streams of it, of me playing on that server once I get it edited. I'm going to do a little bit of work and try to edit the spawn rates of different loot items, so that weapons and ammo in particular will be less frequent. And possibly also food as well. Because if you're going to play on a co-op server, you might as well just make it difficult. So I skipped ahead a little bit. Hope you guys like the centerpiece there. I really liked it, at least. And now we're going to put a little forward command deck on the... something that looks like a forward command deck on the... on the upper level of this hangar in the command station. Yeah, I think it actually got colorful enough. And we have some visiting Endermen who I will kill in between clips of this. So we will no longer have to deal with them. But for now, they are there making noise and being annoying and getting in my way. And yeah, I just don't particularly like Endermen. I don't know what it is. I mean, I don't mean to be racist or anything. But I don't like things that can teleport. Big, lanky things that can teleport. With purplish eyes. Are they purple? Let's have a look. Oh god, it's attacking me. I'm just kidding. That obviously wasn't happening on camera. I'm just kidding with you guys. So yeah, what else can we talk about? Yeah, about the whole live stream thing. I was thinking I might go get myself a Twitch account. Or, I mean, I have a Twitch account, but you know what I mean. Like, set up a Twitch account and start actually using it to stream. So if I can get my brother to teach me how to do the whole Twitch thing and how to get things like my webcam integrated into it and how to get a hold of the files in the event that I want to make like little YouTube clips to put on my channel and so on and so forth. But I just wanted to know if you guys might be interested in that, because it might actually be something that's a little easier for me to do than YouTube at the moment. Another reason I don't particularly like Endermen, they're loud. Loud, really, really loud. So yeah. I'm considering getting myself a Twitch account set up, and then, you know, I can do Twitch videos of me playing on the DayZ server that me and my brother have set up, once I get it set up again. And then you guys can watch as I fumble around for 2 or 3 hours, possibly with Kylan3D9 guest starring occasionally. Oh, failure. Good thing I have this Silk Touch pickaxe. But yeah, if you guys are interested in that, then just, you know, let me know. I might do it anyways, but if I do it, I will make sure to announce on my YouTube channel that I have a Twitch account and that it is up and running. Also, you guys can feel free to follow it anyways. I guess it's called follow, isn't it, on Twitch? I don't really know, because I don't use Twitch that often. But I already have a Twitch account, so it's obviously Gyre3D9, just the same as always. Same as always. So I might consider doing that. I'll want to edit the data files to make the game more challenging, just because it's a little too easy at the moment, especially, you know, for co-op gameplay. Like, if there were enemies in the game, it would be fine. I added in NPCs, but it wasn't working out too well. So anyways, here's the finished product. More or less finished. I'm going to do a little bit more interior work when I have the time. And I know I always say that and then I forget to do it, but I'll try to remember this time. So I like the way it turned out. Like, you have some of the functionality on, like, the exterior, so you can kind of see how it works from the outside and from the inside. Like I said, or actually I didn't say it in this video, I said it in the last video, I wanted it to look minimalistic from the outside, but from the inside I wanted it to look big. And I think I nailed it pretty well. Like, up here it feels kind of cramped, but that's intentional. It's a command center. It's where people are, not where ships are. And we can look out the command deck. Hopefully I'll have stuff out there to look at eventually. Obviously glass on all sides, so you can look out in any direction. It's a nice little panel in the middle. Not quite sure what I want to do with that, but it's a nice panel. It's a panel. And here's the interior of the space station. So anyways, thanks for watching. I will talk to you guys soon. As usual, terrible at ending videos.